Sorry about this, I'm kind of on a limb and I put it in my neck. But anyway, I'm gonna try and see what I can do. And this is called Dan the Man. It's a pretty cool game. There's loads of stuff to do, but at the start you only get a few things. Not too much, but hey. You've got on here, you can be different players. You know, you got Dan, you got Josie. You got some people that you can unlock, and then you got like a character changeable, so you can use whatever you want. And then for all your characters, you can do whatever you need to do and improve his skills. Like, that's got his punches, so he does more. That's got his down kick, so when he jumps and he comes down. But we'll go through all that in a bit. And he's got ultimate high kick, so basically when people are above you, you can do that kick. He kicks above his head. And then grab and throw. Somehow you can throw him, which is nice. And then you can actually grab him and start beating him up, which is pretty fun. But anyway, that's most of it. The basics of this game is it's a sort of like a Mario sort of game, but you know, with Kung Fu, which is quite nice. So, sorry about this, I'm gonna have to sort of finish off what I was doing before. Got bad looks with him at the beginning, anyway. So, as I say, you can do quite a lot of stuff. You can move around as much as you want. Let's say this is on the mobile, so you know, got your health up there. Sometimes you get videos and stuff, and you get little hidden trinkets, and you get that. These to move left and right. You can change it however you want. Sorry about the screen. I had a little bit of an instance. This is you're gonna be your punch button and or your action button. This is your jump button, so you have a little bit of a fight and stuff. When you first start it, all you'll be doing is punching straight. But all you're basically doing is going round fighting people and trying to save something. If you look on YouTube, there's already a lot of videos, which is quite good. But one of them took a little bit of making away. It seemed like it was, well, a bit wrong. I got a shuriken, but you can get other weapons, and it tells you there. And as you can see now, I've got an extra button there. That's for all my weapons, so I can fire them. Most of the times I don't really use them, but they do come in handy. Because you can just, like, totally have them out. And it's pretty cool. It's loads of combinations of buttons, but not too bad. And as you can see, it's not too bad for graphics. As I say, that's the downward kick. And that one pretty much does a lot of damage. It's basically a basic platform game. So if you like platform games, it is very, very good. Don't worry, those aren't enemies yet. They are enemies, but. And as you can see, and the high one is you press the jump button twice. That's because I'm grabbing all of them. And if you want me to show you that, in. So you're looking, it's quite funny. Grab hold of them like Streets of Rage, and you can beat them up like that. Press the punch button to hit them, and then you press the jump button to do a fancy move, which in this case is an uppercut. Those bad boys up there, these are where you might get little trinkets. There is a downside to it.